Everyone's been asking for an update for the build, so we're going to do that. And the first thing we're going to do is build a computer that is cheaper than the current consoles, especially when you take into the fact that everyone is selling these things online for $400 more than they're worth, because it's scarce. It's not scarce to game on a PC. It's not scarce or scary. So you guys ready to get started with a very, very cheap, we're talking like $350 cheap gaming PC. And remember guys, you can do a lot more on a gaming PC than you can on a console. If you guys want to know all of the philosophy behind why we game on PC or why we use PC, click on the screen right here. It'll take you to our video. It's another console versus PC video, but ours is the best. And we don't even talk about graphics because I know with this PC, you're probably going to have better graphics on the current next-gen consoles. Anyway, let's get started off with the CPU. We're going to use an APU and keep it really cheap with the AMD A10 5800K. You're not going to be playing Crysis with this, maybe on the lowest possible settings ever. You're not going to be playing too many of the AAA titles like Battlefield 4, but you are going to be able to play a lot of PC games, tons of exclusives, way more exclusives on PC than there are on console, so you guys can play all those games. Guys, there's a lot of catching up to do. If you've never played like Half-Life or any games like that, some of the first-party games from Valve, you need to play those. The Witcher series, there's a lot of really good PC games that you guys need to check out. So hop into our forum and we can recommend some games that you may have missed out on. System Shock 2, for instance. And you can play that for sure on your 1850-800K. I would not recommend right now spending more money because this is like $100. You can spend like an extra $50 and get a 6800K. If you see one on sale, maybe get a 6800K, but I've got another option coming up at the end where if you wanted to upgrade this and get a dedicated GPU, you can do that. All right, moving right along here, let's talk about the RAM. Now you want really fast RAM because that's an APU, and an APU has an integrated GPU. You're not gonna have a dedicated graphics card. Dedicated graphics cards have their own freaking RAM, so they don't need, like ridiculous RAM. But with this one, you do. Luckily, there's a sale right now, g.skill, the Ripjaws X series. You can get 8 gigabytes of that. And that's 2133 megahertz with a cast latency of 9, and that basically means that it's just going to be a lot of memory moving through that RAM, and that's going to be really good for your APU. And right now it's on sale on Newegg for $59.99. That's really freaking cheap. Next up, the motherboard. We're going to grab an MSI FM2A75MA-E35. This one is just, it's simple. It's got a lot going on. I mean, we've got one PCI Express 16-speed slot. We also have two one-speed PCI Express slots and a PCI slot. So if you've got old like sound cards or whatever PCI laying around, you can put that in there. You can put a lot of things into this. Also, we have DVI, HDMI, and VGA. And what else does we have? Oh yeah, USB 3. And we have a USB 3 header on board. So we'll get a case so you guys can have some front panel USB 3 connectors. I think you'll like that. For the hard drive, we're going to grab a Western Digital Blue 1 terabyte drive. Now the blue drive is sort of the middle of the road drive. It's really good for consumers. And it's on sale, normally $99.59, so I would definitely grab that. I saw like a 750 gigabyte drive for just a few dollars less, so let's spend just a few extra dollars and have more room for games and media. That's what this is all about. All right, for the power supply, let's do the EVGA 500 watt. It's the 500B is the model number, and it's 80 plus bronze certified. That's plenty of power, that's more power. You'll even be able to add a graphics card with the 500 watt power supply, like next year. When you get like, you make some money or something, or you set up a lemonade stand and you make a couple dollars, you can get yourself a graphics card and pop it in there. So that'll do just fine. And for the case, the Rose Will, it's the Challenger US 3. That's just the Challenger, but it's got USB 3. That one, it keeps going on sale. It was like an hour ago, it was like $30 and now it's $48. So if it's $50, you can maybe look at the Fractal. It's the Fractal Design Core 1000 USB 3. Look at that one as well. They're both really good cases. But this one keeps going on sale. I'm not sure why the price keeps going up and down, but just keep an eye out for that. All right, if you guys wanted to make some upgrades, here's what I would do. I would forego the APU. If you have just maybe an extra $100 or something in your pocket, forego the APU and spend $79 on Newegg and grab the Athlon X4 750K. That's a quad core without an APU. And you can overclock this one a little bit, but you're going to need a dedicated graphics card for this one. So you can still use the same motherboard and all that. If you want to spend like a couple, I guess just a couple dollars less than that, you can get like the 740. That one does not overclock really, so they're about the same price, so I'm recommending that. And then for the graphics card, I'm going to give you guys some options. For like $130, you can get a 650 Ti and play a lot of the modern games on like medium settings. There's a gigabyte here. It's also a low profile card, so you can get a really small case with that one. But I recommend that one as a start. Moving up from there, we've got the 270X. And these are going to be hard to find this holiday season because they're really hot. They're about the same speed as a 7870, but they're $200, and you get a lot of speed out of this card. I mean, you can play a lot of the games, a lot of the modern games, on high settings. Maybe not Crysis 3, but Battlefield and that sort of thing you can play on high settings. Around the same price and around the same performance, depending on the game, it's better or worse, you can get a GTX 660. Now, some of these are going to be going on sale soon because, you know, the 7 Series is out from NVIDIA. So check out the GTX 660. And the last one that I'm going to recommend, these are going to be very hard to find, but you can get a 7870 on sale. Like if you see one at Micro Center or on the internet, sometimes they're on fire sale because, you know, people are getting rid of them so they can make room for the, you know, the 270X, the 280X, and the 290X, the new AMD graphics cards. So keep an eye out for those if you find one. They're quite fast for the money, but I mean, really, if they're the same price as the 270X, just get the 270X. That's all there is to it. Last thing, 7850. So I hope I've given you guys a lot of ideas here. The core system at the beginning can be upgraded using those parts. That's the idea. And yeah, if you guys have any questions, click on the screen. It'll take you over to our website where you can post your questions in the comments there, and I'll hop in and check that out. If you think, hey, I've got a better idea, or Logan missed something, or hey, maybe he didn't know about this part that was on sale, post that in the comments as well, and we'll all help each other because, you know, it's time right now where everyone's upgrading, everyone's excited about the consoles, but screw that, man. We got PC, and you can do a lot more with a PC. Play videos, play games. You know, you guys get the idea. You can watch that video on your own time. All right. See you next time.